Hello, everybody.
What did you say, Jim?
I said good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. Booth, Reverend Tom, Reverend Jane Hedner, Douglas, that they are serving with us this morning. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God,
keep all hearts open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may worthily love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God
in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Son of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lord of all power and might, the Father and giver of all good things, grant in our hearts the love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness, and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
My beloved is like his house over the head. Look, there he stands between the wall, gazing in the windows, looking up the lattice. My beloved speaks and says to me, "Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of singing is coming. And the voice of the turbot is heard in our land. The fig tree comes forth as figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my fair one, come away." Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Some points of this morning is in your bulletin, and part of the commentary, page 647. Please respond to the whole verse. My heart is stirring in an old song. Let me recite what I have fashioned for the King. My tongue shall be the pen of a skilled writer.
The Lord there is an end. Praise flows from your lips, because God has blessed you forever.
Your throne, O God, endures forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. You love righteousness, and you hate misery.
Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness.
The music of strings and iron palaces make you glad.
Jesus, stay on the wings of the Lord. On your right hand is the King.
The
epistle this morning is from James 1, 17 through 27. It'll be found in your pew Bible on page 1100 or 1102. Every generous act of giving, with every perfect gift, is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In fulfillment of his own purpose, he gave us birth by the word of truth, so that we would become a kind of fruit of his creatures. You must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger, for your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourselves of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror, for they look at themselves and, on going away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law of liberty, and persevere, be not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. If any think they are religious and do not bridle their tongue, but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A holy gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe: the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines.' You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition." Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they defile a person. The Gospel of the Lord.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
I know, it's been 40 years. By your house before the service? You're early.
About this whirlwind that we've been living in, probably more than just for the pandemic time. But don't you ever feel like you live in the middle of a whirlwind or a hurricane, and there's so much information coming at us, and it makes you crazy? So here's a reading from Nadia. And it's entitled, It's All Too Much. She says, I used to live in a very old apartment building with super sketchy electrical wiring. Were I to audaciously assume my hair dryer could run while my stereo was on, I would once again find myself opening the gray metal fuse box next to the refrigerator and flipping the breaker. My apartment had been built at a time when there were no electric air fryers, and the system shut down when modernity, when those modern things, asked too much of it. You know, I was working outside of our church the other day, which was built in the late 1800s, and we don't have an electrical outlet on the outside of our church. We don't have a faucet on the outside of our church. I am grateful we have restrooms in our church, but there's definitely leftover lack of moderation. So I think that fuse box often these days, because friends, I just do not think our psyches were developed to hold, feel, and respond to everything coming at them right now. Every tragedy, which it seems like we have tragedies daily that we're hearing about, every injustice, sorrow, and natural disaster happening to every human across the entire planet. In real time, every minute of every day. How many of you watch the news at night? I do. Come on, I watch the news. Read the paper. Get on Facebook. We are inundated with information in real time. The human heart and spirit were developed to be able to hold, feel, and respond to any tragedy, injustice, sorrow, or natural disaster that was happening in our own village. But boy, we are inundated with information. So my emotional circuit breaker keeps overloading because the hardware was built for an older time. And yet, when I check social media, it feels like there are voices saying, if you aren't talking about, doing something about, performatively boasting about, and you can fill in the blanks, then you are an irredeemably callous, privileged bigot who is part of the problem. And when I am someone who does actually care about human suffering and injustice, someone who feels every picture that I see and story that I read or hear, it leaves me feeling like crud. I'm left with wondering, am I doing enough? Sacrificing enough? Giving enough? Saying enough about all the horrible things right now to think of myself as a good person and subsequently silence the accusing voice in my head? No. The answer is always no. No, I am not. Nor could I. Because no matter what I do, the goal of enough is just as far as when I started. And yet, to do nothing is hardly the answer. So I wanted to share something with you, or not even wanted to share something with us. Every day of my life, she asks herself three questions that she learned from one of her teachers. And these are questions for us that we can think about. What's mine to do? And what's not mine to do? What's mine to say? And what's not mine to say? We all feel like we have an opinion on a lot of things, but is it ours to say? And the third one is harder. What's mine to care about? And what's not mine to care about? To be clear, that's not to say that it is not worthy to be cared about by someone. Only that my effectiveness in the world cannot extend to every worthy to be cared about event and situation. We can care. We can't make it our own. It's an issue of values. It's not an issue of values. It's an issue of values. So she tries to remember. We are still living through a global pandemic, and that means the baseline of anxiety and grief is higher than ever and shared by everyone. Two, the world is on fire, literally and metaphorically. But three, I only have so much water in my bucket to help with the fires. The more exposure I have to the fires, I have no water to fight, the more likely I am to get hurt and to inhale so much smoke that I cannot help anymore with the fires close enough to fight once my bucket is full again. Do you ever feel that way? I care about a lot of things in the world, but I have one bucket, and I only have so much water for it. And if I spread myself so thin, my little bit of water isn't going to help here and there, here and there. So I try and tell myself that it's okay to focus on one fire. It's okay to do what is yours to do, what's yours to say, and to care about what's yours to care about. And that's enough. If immigration reform is yours to do, if it is the fire you have water to draw on, thank you, and that's enough. There will be voices saying, but what about climate change? You don't care that the planet's dying? Tune that stuff out. I mean, you could turn around and ask the environmentalists next door why they heartlessly don't care about immigrants. But there is no percentage in that. Instead, we could be so grateful for the people who are called to work on and respond to worthy issues that are not fires that we ourselves are equipped to put out. I'm not saying that we should put our heads in the sand. I'm saying that if your circuits are overwhelmed, there's a reason. And the reason isn't because you are heartless. It's because there is not a human heart on this planet that can bear all of what is happening. So thank you for being a person who cares about and responds to animals, or the environment, or immigration, or domestic violence, or any of the other worthy to be cared about stuff that we are in the midst of right now. Just thank you. Think about those things that are important to your heart, are important in your world. And throw your water on those fires. So here's the prayer. Dear God, I am sad to inform you that the planet is on fire. I'm sure he knows that. And that there's a global pandemic that goes on and takes more and more from us. Haiti has been decimated once again. Afghanistan is on fire. And last week, some scientists said some pretty depressing stuff about our planet. It's all a bit much right now, Lord. I don't want to feel numb, but sometimes I do. Except for when I'm having random level 9 responses to a level 2 situation. I mean, it's humbling to admit that yesterday, and I have done this as well, for crying out loud that the guy with the painfully and unnecessarily loud muscle car in front of my apartment. Bless that guy, Lord. Please just show me what is mine to do, because otherwise I will feel horrible not doing everything, or callous for just doing nothing. So give me grace for myself and for others. Also, we notice this, everyone is understaffed right now. So grant us patience with every clerk and delivery driver and customer service rep. And when all I can do is stop during the day and place my hand on my heart and hold all these heavy realities up to you, may it count as a prayer. Help me to know that there is water in my bucket and which fire to throw it on, but also to know when to wait because I am on empty. Help me to trust that you will give me what I am to give away, and to not feel like I must carry water for everyone else. I guess what I'm saying, Lord, is please show us some mercy and help us to show this same mercy to ourselves and to others. Amen.
Amen.
Together,
that your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Have compassion on those who suffer from hand grief and reproach.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Lift the departed from eternal rest.
Let thy presence shine upon them.
We pray for your saints who have entered into joy.
That they may also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
Bless the name of the Lord, and all the glory and Christian and
chicken, but just bring inside. It's at 4 o'clock this afternoon. And if you've never been,
Spend it separate, that's worth just for the food. Any other announcements? If you don't go to the one, the Tri-Parish picnic and service, at 5 o'clock in Douglas, behind our church, we're having a camp player service. You're welcome to that as well. But I don't think you have food for that, right? There's snacks. Are there any birthdays to celebrate today? Anniversaries? No?
Yes.
There. Where is the bride?
Right here.
Let's see. How many years?
33.
33. Let us pray. O God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and His church. Send therefore your blessing upon these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessings and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, the Holy Spirit, one God, and one forever. Amen. Congratulations. Give my hand for you. Is there any
of you? All that you are and all that you have to the table of our Lord.
Thank you.
It is right to be generous and gracious.
God of all power, who art in the earth, who art in the dead, glory to you.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things be achieved. The best stand for the interstellar space, galaxies, sun, the planets and their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, they were created and have their being.
From the front elements, you brought forth the human race, and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation. We turned against you, and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again, you called us to return. The prophets and sages revealed the righteous law, and in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman. He fulfilled your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood, he reconciled us. By his wounds, we are healed.
And therefore, we pray to you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets and apostles and martyrs, and with all of those after generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim to you your glory in their unending hymn. Let the grace of this holy communion make us one body. for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And say together on page 365, so that's great.
Thank you. Thank you.